Hey guys, welcome to the Award at War test tournament 1v1, and this is round 1. Back to round 1. On the lower half of the bracket, we have LiamSmalley, a very exciting new player, quite talented, a bit new, but has been practicing a lot. And this is actually, sorry, this is match 2 of the games. I won't tell you how the first game went, as it's a bit of a spoiler. Liam with a regular squad, and Achantus with a regular squad is Hungary. And if you looked at my MG tutorial, you'll know that the Hungarian MG is actually quite bad. So I think this might go to the Soviets in the center, but actually, you've seen this before, Simus. In Abbey, it takes forever for any of the guys to die in the shootout in the center.
Yeah, the stone wall here, just the cover is just like, no one's going to die in the middle, really. It's just a matter of like, supporting so that no one takes the actual middle flag, essentially. But it looks like Chandis has done a good job actually taking the side flags here. He definitely has the western flag, although he is losing the eastern flag, although he just gunned down one SMG infantry here. He hasn't unlocked the gates. The one thing about Abbey is you actually have to unlock these gates to actually come in.
I guess it's a bit of a map knowledge thing. It's quite easy to do. Just notice that Abbey's infantry range shootout in the center is just above SMG range. That's around 45.2 or something, depending on where you look at. So the SMGs won't fire automatically, I don't think, above 40 range. So it's a completely rifle-dominated shootout map.
Interesting enough, Achantus actually managed to micro as one SMG on the eastern flag and actually takes that flag. That is a nice little start for Achantus, though. We'll definitely let him get on the scoreboard first.
Yeah, three cap. Oh no, not three cap. Center's actually been decapped, so it's not too bad for Liam. He's gone a few single SMGs on the right. He's spreading them out quite evenly. So no huge power anywhere, but I think he might be able to overwhelm Achantus on the western point. Interesting matchup here, Simon. Soviets versus Hungary. It's quite an even battle in terms of infantry. Tank battles, maybe. I don't know, it's going towards Hungary, maybe.
Yeah, I actually really like Hungary. I mean, it's one of the new nations, and not everyone's used to it, but I think Liam's definitely going with his strongest nation as possible. Just being the underdog here, I expect him to not leave anything out on the field here. Nice grenade.
Hey, wait a second. Is Liam's Hungary? Okay, because look at the icons at the top. The icons at the top, Achantus Hungary. Near the timer.
That is weird. Looks like it is messed up for me as well, so.
Okay, so Liam is hungry, yeah, definitely. I guess the icons are being a bit silly, so just to point that out, guys, in case you also get jumbled. Center still, I guess, where's the MG? The MG died somehow, the MG of Liam's. And Achantus now has two MGs in the center. And has sneaky capped the center as well, but Liam has managed to micro his way into the Abbey Church. And has capped that. Now he's got escalation here. He's got the CESPA. One pointer special. And what did, he's got the shock infantry, I guess. Yes, the shock infantry out. And the assault squad had no counter as of yet. I haven't seen an AT rifle anywhere.
I do see an AT rifle for a chance that's sneaking up. Towards the western flag here, towards the middle as well, plus the SASPA.
There it is, yep. Yeah, nothing to the SASPA though. That's what the Soviets need to counter.
Yeah,
he definitely spent a lot in assault squads.
Make it a grenade.
Guy in the ditch. Ooh, that's a nice turning circle. Well, that was totally off.
Yeah, definitely got to keep your light vehicles on the move as much as possible, especially one, he's pushing this really far up, even Rifleman may Molotov him or something.
A nice flank on the sandbags, taking out a few. AT rifle buy from Liam is kind of blocked by that tower, electricity hill mound. Kind of move to the center to get a nicer shot. What's going on? These shots are way off. These guys are definitely on vodka or something else, finally. Hull damaged. So these Russians, they drink vodka, I hear, Simus. I think it's a Saturday night in America. You guys, you like to enjoy a good alcoholic beverage to chill out while watching Game of Mail?
Gin. So, gin's the proper drink of a gentleman.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Gin.
Yeah.
Gin and tonic.
You didn't know that, yeah.
I'm not a gentleman, obviously, yeah. I'm an Australian rat, they call me.
Nice shock infantry by Liam has cleaned up the Western flag here.
Very nice.
Taking down the Sazba and should be able to cap that flag back.
Yeah, he's got a huge majority.
Hopefully get on the scoreboard here.
Yeah, he's actually on the scoreboard. Just the icons are messed up again, remember? 14-0. He's actually leading. Liam is leading Achantus. Achantus, get a background on the players. Achantus came second in the last 1v1 tournament, International 3, losing to Pringles quite convincingly, but otherwise he did beat everyone quite easily. Liam, definitely an up-and-coming player, so good to see Achantus getting his ass handed to him so early in the game by a new player.
Is it me or... Yeah, that Sazba wasn't down initially, and now it is.
Oh, wow, I thought it was down. Okay.
Yeah, originally it wasn't down. Are you looking at the right icons? I see that Achantus is actually up. 14-0, I don't know.
No, that's the icon at the top's wrong, remember? We just explained that.
yeah, I know, but I wasn't believing you, though.
Oh.
Are you sure? AT rifle, nice.
Nice, T60, nice. Oh, wow, has to be so careful versus Hungry. And really, that's the main trump card of Hungary, that AT rifle. It's pretty cool. I want to leave it like that because it gives the motivation of a player to go Hungary, you know? I want that beastly AT rifle.
Yeah, I agree. The AT rifle is definitely a good choice. Hungary is, I think, a pretty strong nation, to be honest with you. It doesn't really have great infantry, per se, but it does have a good AT rifle, and it does have a Hetzer that can definitely come out, so...
Yeah, the SMGs are pretty much the same as Soviet, second best in the game other than Finland,
right.
So
right.
I think they can definitely match infantry as well. Here's a charge. Is that a charge unit? What? I'm really confused now.
Yeah, I think I made a mistake. I think the Kaikons are right. I'm not sure what you're seeing on your side, but...
What?
Hungary's definitely up 14-0.
I think I'm the one that's drunk now, Simus.
That wouldn't surprise me.
Apologies, guys, for that confusion. I don't know how I was confused there. Liam has always been the Soviets, and he's trailing 14-0. He's got to charge out. Obviously, that big Soviet flag alerted me to that mistake.
Nice AT rifle by the Soviets. Actually, taking out the main gun of the 39M Sazba.
Is that
this,
the
is
same?
Is this the 20 mil?
Oh, it's the 20 mil Sazba. Yeah, 20 mil Sazba.
Yeah. Main gunned it. So it's funny because I could see how you'd be confused because both of these nations are actually really similar in like the weapons that they actually put out on the field.
Yeah, no, I actually don't know why I got confused, to be honest.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's only one to forget.
I was just trying to help you out. So.
Arrow across in the center. Interesting. with 20 mil Solothan, it doesn't
what
have...
About this?
Too many HE shells though, and what's been taken out. So it's only 3 HE shells. I think it's suspended them all. That's the defender flanks by Achantus. Another one special point.
Yeah, I was curious about that. He's got an HE rifle, but he's also got the defender flanks. By it seems a little overkill for me. Plus the spot it's in is kind of weird. Can't shoot through this actual like stone walls here. Seems a little weird spot for it.
Yeah, a lot of AT rifle you see, but a nice wow, the Sazba is still alive after the AT rifle shot. It's hull damage though. T-34-76 can definitely take that out. Take everything out. But here's a sneaky arrow cross. The arrow cross does come with 2 Panzer Shreks, which could be lethal. Oh no. So I just fell by the HE shell.
That actually it's funny because that defend the what is that called, defend the line or defend the whatever
the flanks
it's actually below the hill, so it actually can't get shot very well, but it also can't shoot anything in itself. Like it's just in a weird position that it can't do anything.
Yeah, a bit bizarre, but yeah, I don't think 76 is really struggling to shoot it down. It's frustrating for Liam right now. Another one, another miss. Now it's going to try getting infantry charge in. Some collateral damage there. The infantry just got AP sniped. Wow, just really struggling to take it out. It's being so annoying. This is a very funny battle, isn't it? This seems like
yeah,
a fun company
really
of heroes.
Is. Because, like, the way the terrain is. Like,
it's fine. It misses again.
I don't know what to say. This is just funny.
The White guys and you guys watching, this is not, doesn't have hit points, okay? World of War doesn't turn the game into a company of heroes. It's just can't be penetrated.
Thank God.
Wow. Liam can't get into the center flag. He just wants to... yeah, I would pretty much just give up by now. It's, he's tried about 10 times already. 20 times.
Yeah, you see all the dead bodies, like, trying to cap that flag, huh? There's like nine dead bodies, like, right there. That's actually hilarious.
The count is coming soon, and here it is. It's, it's had all the time in the world, yeah, to bank for that Turan 3, and it's got all the benefits of the H, but no, none of the weaknesses, no turret weakness, and ooh, it's got its sight turn. Holy, no. He's going to angle it quite nicely, going to run actually away behind the house perhaps. No, it's stuck. No, it does escape behind the house.
Yeah, that 76 has no chance against the Turan 3. Looks like we do see a sniper by Liam here, although it is getting... No, never
it's
mind.
Two snipers. I think it's the red Moses guard sniper. Yep. The two guard snipers are out. Should do well in the center in the shootout. The shootout is pretty much an everlasting one. And the sniper will definitely shine in this scenario. Quite amazing how things happen, like that Turan 3 actually AP sniped an AT rifle on the other end before. It's quite funny.
Is it me, or did I just see the charge flag just sitting in the river?
Yeah.
Do you see that?
Yeah, when the charge guy dies, he just drops the flag.
Oh, that's hilarious.
So you can kind of trace back the steps to see what happened. That's his last breath of air. Wanted to get a drink of water. Oh, look at the snipers go. Two of them in the same position.
Oh.
Wow, they're missing.
They're like sitting right next to each other, huh? That'd
in
be
a strange
nice
angle, though, it's
there.
Like the fifth shot. They've missed. They're missing everything. Oh, no, not anymore. Two of them sniping the same unit. It looks like he'll run back, run to the flag easy, but that CISPA 39M is back up.
Like, if one misses, the other one will actually hit it, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. I'd probably split them up, but, you know, keep them together.
Unfortunately, that AT rifle being sniped by the Turan 3 is now unable to kill that CISPA. T-34 probably should risk taking a shot at it, because you don't want to leave that 20mm line too long. 46-0, the number 3rd seed of the tournament is doing quite well at the moment.
Yeah, Chanis just noticed exactly what you just said, the T-34 just kind of pulled out, and the CISPA just like went right back in between the cover. And actually still shooting at troops here, may get some more kills as we speak.
Yep. It looks like the CISPA is actually covering the other side of the flag, but it's popping out to shoot. One of the red guys does have an AT rifle, though. He just picked it up.
Liam has done a nice job to actually decap the Western flag. So he actually pushed the guy in there.
Yeah, he has to.
Yep.
Nice.
I guess the sniper helped.
Definitely. The Eastern point, though, is dangerously going to be assaulted soon. Achantus does have a force outside there. Center showdown here. Really doesn't look like it's going to go well for Liam, so he's going to go for the side flags, which is the smart thing to do. The sniper coverage will prove to be the deciding factor, but the 20mm has access to that area too.
Yep, that's what I was just going to say, Stry. Like, the CISPA is actually in a great position. It can actually reinforce the Western flag. Galt here.
Definitely covering two flags quite easily.
Snipers are definitely important, though.
Yeah, I guess the CISPA can try counter them, but it looks like it's playing safe. Sniper's trying to get into the center point as well. They're missing a lot, though. I've noticed they've missed more than usual.
I like this sandbag placement on the Western flag. It's kind of like right in between the... it's in the cap, so you can actually like crawl up there and actually cap the flag. Granted, those guys are dying.
True.
So... Well, you know, it's a try at least. Wow. Yeah, so Eastern flag looks like it's going down, huh?
Yeah, here comes a conscript force from Achantus capping it. Nothing left now from Liam. Liam hasn't got a response. Just a single SMG, probably just for some line of sight to cover his ass. yeah, turning to be quite a showdown in the center and the west, shooting out, and something that the Russian team isn't going to win. Turan 3 is always going to cover them. And that's
a T60. Did you see that T60 come up?
Yeah, it was the run we got repaired, I think.
Gotcha. Just went down. Yeah.
It
was up and then just went down again. Unfortunately. Liam is definitely down. He's down what, 55-0. So. He's got to figure out how to get in the middle or, I guess, back in the eastern flank. So he has an entire charge unit coming. So that should be able to do it, though, just with the numbers. Definitely want to take some losses, but...
Yeah, just conscripts holding.
Should be able to get in
there. Should be able to get in for sure. 58-0. Some red cars just on prone. A lot of them on prone, actually. And then the assault squad coming in. And potentially they're not going to even fire a shot before they get grenaded. That would be quite unfortunate to lose them all. Sniper's relocating. I think the CISPA is onto them. It's trying to take him out.
It's funny because Liam's troops, like half his troops, are prone right now. He's got to figure out a way to just counter that CISPA, right? Doesn't seem like a big unit by any means, but it just can't be countered right now.
Bit hard. 76.
He doesn't have any MP, and he doesn't have any special points, really. He's actually spent all of his special points for the most part. He's got two left.
Yeah, and the red guards, without firing a shot, maybe get grenaded. Yes, they do. Fortunately, not in position of fire. It's a bit of a waste, and looks like Achantus does take the western point, and also has the eastern, but here comes a half-track from Liam. We'll be able to clean it.
Yeah, be careful, he's gonna get grenaded.
Yep.
He's gonna get burnt.
I think the flame just went inside the carriage, misses its mark. Oh, the other flame doesn't, and lands directly on the gunner. Will the
driver... Anyone driving that?
Yep, looks like he's okay there.
Oh wow, he just popped in. Gunned down like three guys. That's awesome. He's kind of lucky, actually.
Revenge. Take out my gunner.
What? What? The guy grenaded himself.
AT rifle, point blank, bam, no chance.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, hungry at its best right there. Dude, if I could feel like 100 of those AT rifles with hungry, you'd win every game. Yeah. Those things are so good. Well, he should still be able to cap that point, though. He does have a few troops there. I mean, nothing good. He's going to probably take out that 50 cal, I assume. But just with the partisan, though, so that shouldn't be killed that long. Looks like the 76 is pulling in for some shots on that Saba here.
Yeah, to be honest, this should have been done a lot sooner. Just knock down the roof of the house, and then that space has nowhere to hide.
Right, I guess that Turan 3 could do the same thing, though, and get him back.
Definitely. That's definitely the priority. Oh, another assault squad coming into the western point. The Soviets definitely have a chance in with the sniper support as well. I think the CISPA's got main gun damage or something. It's not firing back. And there you go.
It's hull destroyed.
Finally. And that T-60 is also being repaired, so this may be okay for Liam. And his MP is kind of ticking up, so potentially in the future he may even have a counter for that Turan 3.
Yeah,
Turan 3 has actually been quite passive. He's been an inactive influencer in the battle, but he's definitely influencing the battle, but hasn't done much other than just sitting there and stopping that T-34.
Yeah, I'm looking at the snipers. They have 19 and 23 kills apiece. That's 42 kills if my math is correct. Very well done. Definitely going to take that western flag. But unfortunately, he lost the eastern. So even still, he's still losing flags. Down 77-0. I mean, he's got to make a move on the middle here. It looks like he's going to reposition some of his troops towards the middle here, just on a different wall.
Yeah.
I'm not sure why, but maybe he should like send one guy in the middle. There you go. Here you go.
He's got the numbers now and the quality of troops here. The snipers are in range of both flags. And should be able to pick him off slowly. And since the Sisper's died, I think that's changed it entirely. And T60 is up, two round three is going to definitely take the shot on it. That's,
you yep. think, right?
Oh, so quickly. Definitely. Oh, nice pick of
76 wish. tries to pop shot it, but no, I don't think it's going to do much.
Nuts, it's going to tickle it. 500.
It's going to scratch it.
20 MP. Looks like he's pushing up even closer. They're very nice play by Liam.
Oh, here comes the ATM tree, though. ATM Ooh. Tree.
Oh, tracked. Bad luck for Liam. Red Guard Bazooka just tracks the Turan 3. He does have two special points left, perhaps just waiting for that another charge or saving it for the snipers. Sniper's definitely doing well in the World at War mod so far.
What does the 57 do with the Turan 3? Does it stand up to it or not really?
Not really. It's 80mm armor all round in front.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't. The only reason why the H gets beaten by the 57 is either they're really close or they get turreted. Can't turret the Turan 3 like you can turret the H.
Maybe. Right.
Have to get an 85 to match it.
Wow, that's expensive too. Granted, he's almost there actually. He's only 40 some MP away from that. But I do see a nice sneaky. What is this?
76 Ooh. Hold it? What?
What?
Wow, is that closer than I expected? 90 range, okay.
No.
Well, actually, let's have a look at that stat on the T-34-76. That's a bit strange. At 90 range, what? No, that doesn't make sense. That doesn't make sense.
Well, I don't think his hull is actually that the armor you said it was. I know his turret is.
No, it's 80-80. It must be
really?
A weak
spot. I
think
the hull is like 50 or something.
Nah, I think the side armor is actually exposed in the front somewhere. You see that where it hit? It's kind of, you know, in between the center and side, and I think that might be counted as side armor. So,
well, having said that, what blew up by the spawn here? Was that a T-60?
Huh.
I think it was.
Don't know. Looks like it.
I think it was. There was a bazooka. I was mentioning that before the Turan 3 went down, but anyways. Wow, what's going on here?
Yeah, you know, 90 range for the 76 gun, that probably could only penetrate around 40-something millimeters of armor. So that's very interesting how that happened. Maybe APC around. I don't know.
I don't know, Trad. I think the hole on that Turan 3 is a little bit lower than... I mean, you're the one that created the mod. I don't know.
I'm sure it's 80, but I think there's a little bit of a problem with the front. We have the sides exposed in the front as well. Parts of the armor is counted the side. I have to look at that. It's interesting.
Hmm. It is getting repaired though, so if it comes back, who knows?
Yeah, 80-4. It does get on the scoreboard. Achantus quick to cap it back, but Liam can come back to take this flag. He's got the numbers and the sniper.
Does he have both snipers up? He still does. Wow.
Yeah, hasn't been counted.
33 and 42. So 75 kills on two snipers. That's very impressive.
Here comes a Stug. Never see the tank destroyers much in 1v1s. To be honest, Germany ones are the only tank destroyers which haven't got a CP buff because they have really, really strong armor, like the Stug with 80, Stug. Where the Soviets one, you can see the CP is very low, like the Su-85 is only 13 CP. So, yeah, we just to see them being used more, but I've never seen a Stug or a reason why someone will get a Stug in the 1v1. And not in default. Oh wow, look at his grenades. Liam holding on with the snipers. One of them's got 35 kills now.
Yeah, I mean between the two of them they almost have 80 kills. It's extremely impressive.
Yeah,
I'm surprised that Chanis hasn't tried to counter the snipers, to be honest with you.
Even the T-60 hasn't really fired at them, really. So, they're being very audacious now, coming straight directly in front of the center flag. They haven't been counted all game, and now they're just gonna come out and get maximum coverage.
If you killed 45 guys, wouldn't you just be like, nah, I'm not gonna die?
Yeah, I'll be feeling quite invincible. I wonder what the Veteran C3 so that will give it plus 20% weapon reload, weapon skill plus one. It's quite a lot of shit to get from being so... Wow, 47 like, kills? Am I reading
47?
This right?
47.
Hey guys, unfortunately I did crash while casting my Simus, and so I'm casting this another day, just so I can give you the complete picture of the game. I forgot what happened. It looks like Achantus was winning, but Liam did come back, and he's got a decent foothold. You can see there's lots of snipers. So on pause, I guess you'll probably be up to date by watching the video, so I'll try to keep up. Wow, red guard here from Liam. He's got a few snipers. And let's see what this Stug can do. Oh, interesting Stug by. Forgot about that. So two snipers in the field. I guess it's from the red guard squad. 82 to 10. 25 minutes in the game. It's quite a long one. Oh, but I guess the Turan 3 is being repaired. Once that gets repaired, it's going to be quite hard. There's also the Arrow Cross soldiers coming in. Definitely a favourite. Oh, wow. Panzerfaust, what was that? Whatever that was. Missed. Let's see what's happening. Guard's rifle coming in. Interesting, right? Yeah. I'm curious how it goes, Guard's rifle. Anti-tank rifle versus the Hungarian. I'm pretty sure the Hungarian one's better, but won't be much in between, I think. Class and sniper, relocating. Assault squad at the spawn. But getting back to point, I guess he's got that Stug just doing AP sniping. I guess nothing else to use it for. Sniper trying to pick off his troops. He's got a sneaky SMG tapping. Sorry for the disjointed cast, a little bit lost at the moment. So, MP-wise, I think Liam can buy really hard counter if he wants to. SU-85 potentially. Haven't seen tank destroyers much, but I think they're more viable. SU-122, look at the CP on these tank destroyers, they're very low. But the German ones aren't because of the armor. And they're generally good for their price, in my opinion. Chantas has sneaky kept the center. Liam, I guess it just hasn't been spamming. You really should try an assault here, too. There's, I guess, the Arrow Cross here, paratroopers, or Panzerfaust. But definitely a potential assault there, or even just a squad. A squad plus a light vehicle half track. Our track swing onto the right. There's right, well, the Turan 3 is up and the Stug, so I guess there's no real point fighting them unless he wants to really kill them. He can go the SU-122, which would work. Though it's too late in the game, he really should be attacking this point, in my opinion. That doesn't look like. What's he got? Okay, so instead of going that, he's going the 85, which can take out these units too. Gotta be careful though with the angle. The angle is 47 body, you can see. It's not too good. If it's frontal facing, it definitely needs the 45 degree angle, pretty much. He's going all yellow on it. 45 degree angle, mate. What's going on? Ooh, nice crew engine, but it's being attacked by two and isn't an optimal angle. I guess he... Oh, hull damage. Nice. Get the Panzer the Stug now. Let's go repair this. 94 points is there. A Panzer Shrek from the Arrow Cross soldier. Oh, nice. That's fantastic. This guy got killed and he... Oh, wow. That was... Oh. That was really, really unlucky. Anyway, guys. Looks like... maybe he can come back in. No, he's gone. See if this Stug can face off with the 85. 85's got a decent angle on it. Red guards and the sniper coming in. Real desperation and capital here for Achantus. So one still Achantus. That was actually match two, guys. If you weren't aware, I'm not sure if I mentioned it. I only want to say that it was the second match and Achantus come the first, because usually when I do that, it's pretty much the guys won the first game. So Achantus, the third seed from Germany, he's through. He's going to face off the winner of Sausages, Stab, and Thompson. Good luck to, good luck to Achantus. Oh, just want to say, I'm going to try to do some analysis after the game more with the units and their buys. If anyone's interested, I had a few comments that you guys are. I'm actually interested as well, so I will do that in the future. Just this one, I'm just too disjointed with the cast because I crashed, so this was actually casted about 5 days ago, so I'm just filling the gaps. See you around. Bye.